Today, we're calling out countries like Canada, the United States, Saudi Arabia, and many more for cheating. And they're cheating on what might be the most important math test of all, climate change. Because at its core, solving climate change is basically a math problem. The amount of carbon released on our planet minus the amount of carbon that gets sucked up equals the total amount of planet-heating carbon that goes into, or comes out of, the atmosphere. To ace the test, at least as far as our planet's health is concerned, countries need to make their carbon release numbers as small as possible, their carbon sucking up numbers as big as possible, or ideally, both. The math, at least, seems pretty straightforward. But instead of actually solving the problem, many countries are cheating. Hi, I'm David, and this is Minute Earth. A while back, almost all of the countries in the world got together and agreed to drastically cut the amount of carbon they were sending into the atmosphere, and to share their carbon release numbers and carbon sucking up numbers every year to show their progress. And even though there are no real penalties for underperformance, that progress looks, a little promising. But when climate scientists check the math using satellites, they find that not only are the reported numbers wrong, but also that we're pumping more carbon into the atmosphere than ever before. In other words, countries are fudging the numbers to make it look like their net carbon emissions are way lower than they actually are. There are a few different ways that countries are cheating. Some countries are deflating this part of the equation, the amount of carbon they release. Several oil-producing countries, including the United States, don't seem to be counting the huge amounts of carbon that get released during oil production safety operations known as flaring. And Saudi Arabia seems to have forgotten to count any of the carbon emitted by running its largest oil refinery. Other countries artificially inflate this part of the equation, the amount of carbon they suck up. The scientists in charge of Malaysia's reporting claim that the trees in their country's forests somehow suck up carbon 4 times faster than those in neighboring Indonesia, even though the forests in both countries are very similar. And basic forest ecology suggests that Indonesia's numbers are the correct ones. And other countries mess with both of those parts of the equation. In its reporting, Canada, which has huge forests, doesn't include the millions of tons of carbon that get released when mega wildfires burn down trees. They justify leaving those numbers out by arguing those fires are not caused by humans, and thus the carbon emitted by them shouldn't be counted. But Canada does give itself credit for the millions of tons of carbon getting sucked up by other older unlogged forests, which is also thanks to Mother Nature, and not humans. That funny math has allowed Canada to claim that its logging industry, which clear cuts more than 9 hockey rinks worth of forest every minute, is actually about carbon neutral. But if you really include all of the numbers, Canada's logging industry releases about 75 million tons of carbon into the atmosphere every year, roughly as much as the entire country of Colombia. And there are tons of other examples out there of countries cooking the books when it comes to carbon reporting. These deceptive practices don't just make it difficult to figure out whether countries are meeting their goals. They make it hard to know how humanity is doing on our collective goal. To ace this existential math test, we're all going to need to show our work. Thanks to Nature Canada and the Natural Resources Defense Council for their help in producing and sponsoring this video. Researchers and scientists from all across North America are worried about the destruction of Canada's boreal forest and its impact on climate change and biodiversity. Nature Canada and NRDC are working together with Indigenous peoples, environmentalists, and governments to bust the myths around so-called sustainable forestry. You can learn more about their work by visiting naturecanada.ca/lostinthewoods. That's naturecanada.ca/lostinthewoods. Thanks!